Before I can create or manage a tour, I first must set my security scheme. First thing I'll see is a prompt for a user and password. PI Manual Logger, when it's first installed, comes with one default user that is named piml. And the password is piml as well. Manual Logger has its own users and groups that are apart from the regular PI security. The best way to think of this is these users and groups determine who can manage the tours and also collect data on the tours, while PI security can determine who can do actual PI data entry or who has the rights to write to PI data tags. So first I will bring in the Manage Users and Groups display.
Once the user management display comes up, see there's an existing group, PIML admins, and user, PIML. PIML is what we initially used to log in to PI Manual Logger. As we see from the description, this is the admin user, and this is the administrator's group. This user, and then any member of this group, can perform any task in PI Manual Logger. This includes security, creating users and groups, setting global options, building tours, setting the databases that it's linked to, etc. These are the super user and the super user group of PIML. I'd like to supplement this existing security scheme. I'm going to start with something simple. First, I'm going to create a group. I'll use the New button. This group is going to be for data entry, so I'll name it accordingly. Then I'll create a user as well. Again, I'll use the New button. And then I'll enter a password. Now I'm going to make this user a member of this group. I can do that one of two ways. I can either go to the properties of this user or the properties of the group. I'll go to the properties of the group. I'll see user membership. I can do an add here. I have a choice of all the users that exist. The reason I'm doing this is all permissions on tours are set based on groups. So when I go to build my tour, I'm going to set the data entry group to data entry only. I'd like to have a little more granularity in my security scheme. I'd like to have a group and set of users that can modify tours and approve data, yet not have all of the rights of PIML admins. So I'm going to add a new group and new user. I'll do this through that same process, first clicking on the New button. Do the same for the user. Enter a password. And now I'll make this user a member of that group. I'm going to go to his settings, group membership. I can add him to that group. Note that he can be a member of multiple groups. I'm going to add him to data entry only as well. I'm going to say OK here. Also, we've created a very simple case here. We'll have one user per group. Obviously, we can have multiple users per group. The way we're going to use this security scheme is the data entry only group will be the group of users that can do data entry on tours. PIML supervisors, this will be the group that can create, modify tours, and approve data sent to PI. PIML admins will leave that as its default access, meaning that it has any privilege within PIML admins. I can come back to the user management display at any time, add or remove groups and users, set passwords, etc. One thing to note also, the PIML admins group, it gets its super rights from a setting. If I come to Tools, Global Options, look under Security Settings, here's where I define what the admin user group is, and by default it's PIML admins. I'm going to leave this for now. Now that I've finished my manual logger security, I want to go over to PI and set my PI security. Remember, PI manual logger security works in tandem with PI security. To configure PI security, I'm going to use the PI System Management Tools. So I go to the PI System Menu Group, PI System Management Tools. What I'll be doing here is setting security such that my PIML users can write to PIML tags. So this is much the same exercise I'd do for any type of data entry for tags, such as for interfaces. First, I'm going to the security plugin, and then to identities, users, and groups. I'm going to create a new identity that's expressly intended for PIML data entry. Now what I'd like to do is tie this to a Windows AD principle, so I'm going to use a mapping. This is the best practice versus using a trust. So I'll click on Mappings. So now I'll create a mapping to the newly created identity. What I'm going to do is create this mapping. I'm going to go search for a Windows user or group. In this case, I have a Windows group created for my PI Manual Logger users. This is a local group, but it could be a domain group as well. So I see here I've got PIML users. And now I'm linking that to that identity I just created. So any user that belongs to this group will be authenticated into PI as this PI identity. Now that I've created my mappings, I need to address PI tag security. I'm going to come over to Points, Point Builder. I have some previously created PIML tags. I prefixed these all with PIML to make them easy to find. I'll select one as an example. I'll come over to the Security tab. I see that I have the default point and data security. What I need to do is add my identity for both point security and data security. PIML users need read access on point security and rewrite on data security so that they can write to the tags. So I'll do an add here, pick my identity, and I'll set him to just read. I'll come over to data security, add him again, and ensure that he has read write. Then I'll save my tag. This completes my security configuration. Let's review what I've done. On the manual logger side, I've created a group and a user designated for data entry. Within PI, I've created an identity for the same purpose. That identity is mapped to a Windows group. That Windows group would contain my Windows users that would be my manual data entry users within manual logger. Finally, I set my tag security. I used that identity, added it to the tag, gave it read permissions on the point, and read write permissions on the data.